Representative Frederica Wilson calls Trump sick man, attacks his mental health. Democratic Representative Frederica Wilson of Florida called President Donald Trump a sick man last week following comments she claimed to have overheard during Trump's phone call to the widow of a U.S. Special Forces soldier recently killed in Niger. According to The Hill, some Democrat lawmakers are joining Wilson in questioning Trump's mental health, consulting experts in the field who share their interest in removing Trump from office. Appearing on CNN's New Day, Wilson told Allison Camerota that the president is a sick man. "He's cold-hearted, and he feels no pity or sympathy for anyone," she said. Representative Jackie Speier, a California Democrat, explained to BuzzFeed News why she has consulted mental health professionals regarding Trump's fitness to perform his job. "It's one thing from my non-professional, non-clinical standpoint, to believe that someone does not have the capacity to do the job. It's another thing to talk to experts and those who can deal with mental psychosis on a daily basis, so I wanted to hear from them," Speier said. Bandy Lee, a psychiatry professor at Yale, said six Democrats from the House and Senate have contacted her during the last several months to discuss Trump's mental health. Although Speier is not among the legislators who have contacted Lee, she said that she has contacted two other experts regarding the president's mental health. Speier spoke with Baltimore psychologist John Gartner, who is the founder of Duty to Warn, a network of politically active mental health experts across the country who appear to be disregarding the rules of their profession by diagnosing a public figure who they have not personally evaluated. Duty to Warn borrowed their name from the Duty to Warn law in many states, which requires mental health professionals who perceive that a patient might become dangerous to report their concerns, or risk legal liability. According to the Baltimore Sun, Gartner has emerged as the leader of the group of approximately two dozen mental health professionals. The group formed after Gartner posted an internet petition on change.org seeking to remove Trump from office by utilizing the 25th Amendment, which broadly outlines the procedure for ousting a president who is unable to discharge the powers and duties of his office. Although the petition has garnered more than 67,000 signatures since it was posted in January, it has also drawn criticism from Trump supporters and bona fide mental health associations. The American Psychological Association advises members against assessing the mental health of individuals they have not examined in person, while members of the American Psychiatric Association are prevented from the act altogether under the Goldwater Rule. Even so, the members of Gartner's group, none of whom have directly evaluated Trump in a clinical setting, contend that he is deeply and dangerously psychologically disordered. Others in the mental health industry have rebuked the members of Duty to Warn, arguing that their so-called diagnosis of Trump has little clinical basis, risks the professional credibility of those in their field, and stigmatizes mental illness. Alan Francis, former chairman of the Department of Psychiatry at Duke University, told BuzzFeed News, "The solution to Trump is not psychological name-calling, it's political action."